Welcome to online classes for first year students from Kakatiya Graduate Junior College, Narsaraponpeta. Now the subject Physics 1, Class 2. Now we are discussing about work for and energy. This is the important unit for first year physics. First of all, we are discussing fundamental of this unit. Now, first, what is the physical quantity? What is the physical quantity? Physical quantity. The meaning of the physical quantity. Any quantity which can be measurable, that quantity is known as physical quantity. For example, mass, it is measurable. Length, it is also measurable. Time also, it is the measurable. These are physical quantities. What is the physical quantity? Any quantity which can be measurable, that quantity is called physical quantities. Okay. The physical quantities are of two types. One is vector, another is scalar. What is the meaning of the vector? Vector means any physical quantity which has a magnitude and a direction. That quantity is known as vector. It has magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction. Quantity is called vector. Now example, well, so displacement, velocity and force at a stop. What is the vector? The physical quantity which has both, what is the magnitude and direction, then the quantity, physical quantity is known as vector. Example, displacement, velocity and force at a stop. And scalar. What is the scalar? It has only magnitude but no direction. The quantity is known as scalar. Good. Now, it has only magnitude, but no direction. This is known as scalar. The example for scalar. Example. What is the scalar? Now, here displacement. Here distance. Now we have the displacement is as a vector. Distance is a scalar. Velocity and here speed. Work. Power. Okay. These are known as what is the scalars. Okay. Now second, what is the physical quantity? Any physical quantity which can be measurable, that quantity is called physical quantity. Example, mass, it is measurable. Length, it also measurable. Time is also measurable. This quantity is called physical quantity. Actually, physical quantities are two types. One is vector, another is scalar. Vector means the physical quantity which has a magnitude and direction, that quantity is called vector. Example, displacement and velocity, force, etc. What is the scalar? The physical quantity which has only magnitude but no direction, that quantity is called as scalar. Example, distance, speed, work, science. Now let's discuss about product of the vectors. Next, product of vectors. The product of vectors are two types. One is dot product or scalar product. Another is cross product. or vector product. Vector product. Okay. The product of vectors are two types. One is a dot product, and the other scalar product. Another is a cross product or vector product. But now discussing only dot product and scalar product. Important topic. Now dot product. Dot product or scalar product. Scalar product. This is the problem. What is the definition of scalar or dot product? The dot product of the two vector is equal to the product of magnitude of two vector and cos the angle between two vector. First of all, this formula. Now we have considered two vector, which is the A vector. Dot product is known as is denoted by dot and B vector. Now can we A vector dot B vector, that is equal to A magnitude of A and B magnitude of B cos theta. Then A vector dot B vector, that is equal to A B cos theta. It is the formula of dot product. Now the definition of dot product. The dot product of the two vectors is equal to the product of magnitude of two vector and cos angle between them is known as dot product. Now two vectors, it is the A vector and B vector, the angle between two vectors is known as theta. If another definition, the dot product of the two vector is equal to the product of magnitude of two vector and angle between two vector is cos theta is known as dot product. Now simply A vector dot B vector is equal to AB cos theta. Now here, now A vector, it is the A vector, the magnitude of vector is known as simply A, and B vector, the magnitude of B vector is known as simply B, it is the vectors. Now discusses properties of dot product. Dot product. Okay. The first property, the dot product is obey the commutative law, and now it is obey the distributive law or commutative law. Commutative law. That means A vector dot B vector is equal to B vector dot A vector. It is the commutative law. And another is it is obey the distributive law. Distributive law. Then A vector dot B vector plus C vector is equal to, now this is the product of the total dot product. It is distributive. Now we can write A vector dot B vector plus A vector dot C vector. It is known as distributive law. And third property, if the two vector are parallel to each other, it is the A vector and B vector. Now we observe these are parallel to each other. What about the angle between two vector? Then theta is equal to 0. But the dot product definition, what is the formula? A vector dot B vector is equal to AB cos theta. Now from the dot product formula, A vector B vector is equal to AB cos theta. But these are parallel to each other. Then theta is equal to how much? 0. Then cos 0 is equal to 1. Then cos 0 that is equal to 1. Then A vector dot B vector is equal to AB. What happened? When the two vectors are parallel to each other, Then the dot product of the two vector is equal to the product of magnitude of the two vectors. Once again, when the two vectors are parallel to each other, then the dot product of the two vector is equal to the product of magnitude of two the vectors. It is the third property and fourth property. If the two vectors are perpendicular to each other, it is the A vector and B vector. These are perpendicular to each other. What about the angle between two vectors? This angle is then theta is equal to 90. From the dot product definition or scalar product definition, A vector dot B vector is equal to AB cos theta. But theta is equal to how much? Then theta is equal to 90. But cos 90 that is equal to 0. Then A vector dot B vector that is equal to 0. Here, when the two vectors are perpendicular to each other, then the dot product of the two vectors is become to 0. It is the fourth property of the scalar product. For now,